anything that alters a price is now what Google considers to be misleading to the shopper. Therefore, they're going to cut the fee. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Surge. Today, we're going to talk about how to run effective Google shopping ads with variant product pricing. So, Duran, we have tons of customers that have variant products, and they're always running into the same issue when they're trying to run these Google shopping campaigns. So talk to me about what exactly it means to have a variant product and variant product pricing.
Well, let's say you have an e-commerce site. It doesn't matter if it's on BigCommerce, Volusion, Shopify. They almost all treat options of products the same way. So let's say I sell this jacket, right? Let's say I have three sizes, small, medium, and large. And let's just for the sake of the argument say the small one is $100, the medium is $120, and the larger one is $150. What happens is in the structure of these e-commerce platforms, you have only one page for that product, right? So as I select the options, what needs to happen is the price needs to dynamically change and your URL needs to reflect that dynamically changed price. Because if that's not the setup, when you submit your product feed to Google, Google is going to look at your product page and say, this product is $100. However, when I go to your site, I see two other pricing and it's going to automatically reject your data feed. And a lot of people are having this problem right now.
Yeah, absolutely. We're seeing this problem all the time. So, and again, when you're, let's say you're on BigCommerce, BigCommerce has a direct integration with Google Shopping. However, their feed does not have the ability to differentiate the variants based on the products that you're selecting. So what are some of the solutions out there for these e-commerce store owners that are trying to run Google Shopping campaigns for the products that they have that have different variant pricing? And it could be variants, it could be quantity thresholds, right? So bundled products as well. Anything that alters a price is now what Google considers to be misleading to the shopper. Therefore, they're going to cut the feed. So what are some of the solutions out there for these store owners?
Well, you know, we have clients who do custom packaging. And we could do one product page, and I call them landing pages, you don't like it, because those are landing pages for Google AdWords and paid search. One product page could have literally 1,000 different prices based on the size, based on the strength of the material you're picking, based on how many quantities you want, right? So if you submit this product page to Google, you're going to get rejected. The most expensive, but the right way to do it is to implement functionality on your e-commerce site where your URL automatically changes with a parameter every time an option is selected that has a different price or an add-on price. This is the right way to do it, and we will post some examples of that in this post. However, there are other ways. For example, you can use a third-party tool like GoDataFeed. It doesn't 100% solve this problem, but it partially solves this problem. And if you don't do those first two, every single product page that you have that has variants with different pricing is going to get rejected by Google.
Yeah, absolutely. And the third-party tools like GoDataFeed, they work on a per URL basis. So the more products you start to add to your store, the more costly that tool starts to become. And again, that's something that you're paying for every single month. That's why we suggest invest in a functionality that is going to allow your e-commerce store to scale. Regardless of how many additional products you add, with additional variants you add, that is going to be a technology that your site essentially owns.
So if you have a few hundred products, it's really easy to fix this problem where we're running into both issues now. You know, we're consulting clients who have these pages set up the right way with variants. We're also consulting clients who don't have one specific product page and they just have thousands and thousands of variant pages as individual products. So there is a big dilemma here, because if you don't have it set up the right way, it's a problem, because you are going to have a lot of indexed product pages and you're going to dilute your authority for your e-commerce site. And if you have it set up the right way, and if you have over 1,000 products with, let's say, a combined 10,000 variants, what's going to happen is your product fees are going to get rejected. And AdWords is not the only one that's doing this. A lot of marketplaces that accept these URLs and feeds are basically doing this because they want to make sure that when they advertise a product and a price, or let's say a variant of a product and a price, when somebody clicks to that page, they see the right price. Otherwise, it becomes switch and bait.
Yeah.
Right.
No, I'm glad you mentioned that because we said Google Shopping. However, the same exact issue happens on Facebook.
Correct.
Right. If you're trying to run ads on Facebook with varying product pricing, Facebook's going to deny your ad. It's going to get shut down. And in some cases, worst cases, your ad account actually gets taken down. And going through that appeal process is something that I wish upon not even my worst enemy.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, we know how Facebook support is, and it's only going to get worse with everything else that we're seeing going on with Facebook right now and their battle with Apple. So in the most nerdy way possible, Duran, tell me what the solution is in just a few sentences.
Got it. So what we do is we implement a JavaScript that calls the API of your e-commerce platform and product selection. Let's say BigCommerce, right? And what that JavaScript does is it will check all the variants and the different prices, and it will adjust your URL and your parameters accordingly. So if I have this jacket, again, small, medium, large, let's say the website is mysite.com. So if I go to mysite.com/brown jacket? =M, then I know that I'm going to hit the medium version and it's going to be auto-selected on the product page. That is $120. That is the main solution. I know it's hard to understand because we're talking about it. We'll post some screenshots on this post for you, and we'll talk to you guys next week.